Good morning. I'm Jeff Vaughn. This morning's Newsmaker interview is with San Antonio Mayor Julian Castro and the city's 2012 bond proposal. Voters will decide on an almost $600 million bond come Election Day, May 12th. Mayor Castro is in favor of the measure and joins us live to discuss the issue. Mayor, good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you so much for coming in.
Thanks for having me.
This is a big issue. I know that you are in favor of it. Tell us, why does the city need this?
Well, the city needs this for two reasons. First, we're one of the fastest growing cities in the United States. We grew by over 220,000 folks in the last decade. We also have a tremendous amount of infrastructure needs in the older parts of the city. So to meet new growth needs plus the old urban neighborhood needs, it requires a significant investment in streets, in drainage, in parks, in libraries, in our fire stations, really in the nuts and bolts of what cities do and what contributes to the quality of life in neighborhoods.
Mayor, I'd like to go through a breakdown here of exactly where the money is going. It's $600 million, and we could take a look here. And I'd like you to comment on what you think is the most important. I'm sure all of this is important, but if you take a look, once you break it down, $337 million for streets, infrastructure, bridges, sidewalks, $128 million for flood control, $87 million parks and rec, $29 million museum and cultural arts, $14 million for public safety. Any of those jump out at you as the most important?
All of them are important, but of course I think the most basic investment that we make as a city is in our streets and our sidewalks.
Yeah.
But you take any of them are important to quality of life. Drainage, I can't tell you how many families I've visited with over the years, and people know this across town, that when it rains a little bit, you know, their garage floods, the drainage in their area is not good. Our parks, we're a growing city. You go out there in the city, you see more folks running in the park. You see them exercising, wanting to get fit. There's more of a demand on parks. We need to invest there. And then our fire stations, our libraries, those are basic as well. So our main message to folks is that, you know, this is not gravy. This is sort of the meat and potatoes of what cities do.
I know in some of the promotional, as part of the promotional campaign of this, I've heard that there will be no taxes involved. And I would like you to explain that, because a number of people say that there will be some new taxes. So how can we do this without raising taxes?
Well, we can do this without raising taxes because we've allowed our debt capacity to build up. We dedicate 22 cents of the taxes that we already collect to servicing our debt. And so we couldn't do it without a property tax rate increase if we did one of these every year. Mm-hmm. But because we've waited 5 years and defeased other debt, we have the ability to actually do this without a property tax rate increase. It's also worth noting that the city actually has not raised its property tax rate since 1990 or 91, over 20 years. And we've actually lowered it 3 out of the last 6 years, even though we had the 2007 bond issue that was almost as big as this one. So look at the track record. We have a very good track record.
Does financial stability include as part of the reason why no new taxes, because of the strength of the city's bottom line? Is that part of the issue as well, too?
It is. I think when you compare San Antonio to any big city in the United States today, it compares very favorably. We're the only city in the top 10 by population to have a AAA bond rating for our bonds with all of the major rating agencies. We've made the tough budget cuts during these last few years so that instead of raising taxes, we cut our budget and we have to balance it by state law. So there's no question that that fiscal responsibility pays off when it comes time to do one of these bond issues.
Well, when it comes to anything like this, obviously you have people that are opposed to it. I'm just going to give you some information from Bob Martin, president of the Homeowner Taxpayer Association. He believes that this bond will cost taxpayers $830 million, and he believes that there is a clause in there that would allow the city to raise taxes. Explain.
Yeah, you know, I respect Bob a lot. I know that he's been at this for quite a while. They actually have opposed, I think, almost all of the bond issues. I would just say, again, to look at the track record of the city. Now, can we absolutely guarantee that under no circumstances would there ever have to be a raising of the property taxes? Of course not. But all of our forecasts and the track record that we've established over the last 20 years, the strong fiscal position of the city dictates that we're not going to need to do that.
Right.
So we can confidently say, look, this won't include a property tax rate increase.
And Mayor, before we wrap up, I think it's an important point. It was mentioned early on, it might have been a misconception that streetcars were involved in this and the VIA line is a part of this bond. Is that true or not?
There is no funding for the streetcar project As part of the bond ordinance and in the bond covenants, the city council actually put in that no money can be used, even if we have savings, no money can be used for that streetcar project. And none of the streets that are being improved are along the route of that streetcar project. So it's a completely different project. We wanted to make sure that folks are aware of that, and so that's why we took that action at City Hall.
There is an anti-tax sentiment out there. So what do you believe would happen to the city and this issue if it didn't pass?
It would be a setback for San Antonio. I mean, here we are. We've done very well over the last couple of years, even during this recession. The private sector, the nonprofit sector, and the public sector working together. San Antonio is enjoying a lot of prosperity compared to most big cities. Most big cities would love to be in the position that we're in. These are basic investments, and so it would be a real setback if it didn't pass.
Mayor, I thank you very much for your time. I really do appreciate it.
Thanks a lot, Jeff.
And for more information on this bond, just go to our website at kins5.com. Have a great day.